Hi everyone, my name is Anna Barhudarian and I am from Microsoft Azure ED team. Welcome to the series on Zero Trust Session Management. In this first episode, we will discuss how sessions were traditionally managed. In the following episodes, we will talk about Zero Trust Session Management and how it is different from traditional session management. Before jumping to session management, let's do a quick primer on modern authentication protocols. For this discussion, we will focus on the most basic authentication flow. In the most basic authentication flow, you have three actors: a user that requires access to data, a service that provides resources, and a service that provides identity. A user can be a human, or an app, or a software process, or a device. An email or a document server are good examples of a resource provider. A service that provides identity is called an identity provider. Azure AD is an example of an identity provider. In a basic authentication flow, user needs to obtain authentication token from the identity provider. This token will be later used to grant access to data. User starts by sending credentials to the identity provider. In a modern enterprise, data access is often guarded by policies set by the enterprise IT. For example, there might be a policy that requires multi-factor authentication or a managed device. The identity provider validates that user has a valid account, checks policy compliance, and only then issues a token to the user. This token is usually valid for 1 hour. It is important to know the token time span because it controls the duration of an authentication session. The user sends the token to the data provider that in turn validates that the token was issued by a valid identity provider and grants access to the user. Data access is governed by the expiration of the token. Until the token expires, the user continues having access, even though the security stance might change. Remember that a typical token lifetime is 1 hour? So if a user was terminated or their account was compromised in the first 10 minutes into the session, there is no way to terminate the session until the token expires. To work around this limitation, IT departments often reduce token time span, which, as we established already, controls session duration. This is a traditional session management, pre-configuring session duration. Now tokens can last 10 or 15 minutes instead of 1 hour. It means that policies will be validated every 10 or 15 minutes and sessions could be revoked quickly if needed. Sounds great, right? But it also means constant redirections to the identity provider, which can affect user experience. Extra network redirects can affect performance. And more importantly, it could affect productivity. Even with a minor, intermittent identity provider outage, users will lose access within minutes. There got to be a better way to manage sessions. Let's talk about it in the next video. Thank you for watching.